and welcome back to CT News, where we give you the news.
Attention NHS members, be sure to get your service hours done and turn in your dues to Ms. Ligenfelter.
Looking for a Valentine? Take Cupid's Compatibility Survey hosted by the Art Club. The cost is $3 and grades 9 through 12 can participate. Signups are posted outside the art room and will be sold in the cafeteria from February 1st to the 9th.
Rotary Interact encouraged everyone to bring in grocery bags to help support the recycling initiative and the effort to make a bench out of all the recyclables.
Sun Club will be selling carnations to be delivered on Valentine's Day. Students can sign up for carnations with a message to that special someone in room 218.
Attention all seniors and juniors. Be sure to sell your popcorn to raise money for the senior trip and prom. All orders are due February 1st.
See you next week. Stop.
High with a high of 39 and a low of 29. Sunday is also cloudy with a high of 41 and a low of 31.
Welcome back to your sports updates.
The boys' varsity basketball team traveled to United but lost 54-56.
Varsity wrestling hosted United Tuesday night but just fell short.
Girls varsity basketball defeated Ferndale 41-34.
Varsity rifle defeated Berlin this week by a score of 1,315-1,180.
The boys basketball team will host Conroe Valley tonight for senior night.
Congratulations to Ethan Black for committing to Penn State football.
See you next week on Contownian Network.
Shout out to Hannah Swank for committing to female volleyball at Bloomsburg University. Have fun. Shout out Tyler Weber for committing to Mount Aloysius. First baseman, baseball.
There's only one segment above us. That is the alpha male. Other than that, we're number two. Bachelor.
Johnstown.
Low of the low.
Today we have Brooke McDermott joining us as our athlete of the week. How do you feel about your upcoming meet?
Feeling pretty confident. Swim practice has been going well. We've all been practicing pretty hard.
What are your goals for the season?
Just to get personal best and do as best as I can.
How's the team looking this year?
We're doing pretty good. We have 3 out of 4 of us have qualified for districts, and we're hoping to get that last person to qualify.
What are your future plans following the season?
I'm hoping to go to college to swim. I haven't decided where yet, though.
Who do you think your biggest competition will be?
Johnstown.
Thank you for joining us, and good luck.
Thanks.
Nobody cares. Actually, I'm sorry for saying that. Personally, I've never watched it. I just personally don't enjoy it. I'm not going to say I hate it, because Mrs. DeBarlow taught me not to say hate. But personally, it's not for me. But other viewers may be entertained by it, but personally, I am not entertained.
Okay, I'm here with Nathaniel Snowberger, a.k.a. Student of the Week. Snowy, what makes you Student of the Week?
I've been studying hard for this main heart final, and whenever you see my score, I think that'll really determine whether or why not I'm Student of the Week.
I'm excited to see that score. All right, I'm here with Mr. Mainhart. Mr. Mainhart, how's Nathaniel Snowberger going to do on his test?
You mean the government final?
Yes. Yeah.
Adequate.
Adequate. What do you think about your fellow peers' commitment to PSU?
Ethan, he's been like my best friend since little school, and
A is for apple.
I'm like a proud dad watching him get that commitment.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Give me a man after midnight. Want somebody help me chase the shadows away. Give me a man after midnight. Take me through the darkness to the break of the day.
This week we're here with Jake Gregg and Zach Petrie. They're going to be competing in a hot spice challenge, so you can go the longest. So, Jake, you're going to be competing in. Have you been preparing at all for this event?
No.
How far are you willing to push yourself for this competition?
I'm going to go beyond my limits on this one. I'm really going to try hard to beat this guy. It's a tough component, but I think I can take him, me personally. Do you really want to? Do you really want to?
How much of your raw emotion and rage are you going to channel into consuming these peppers?
You know, I'm not going to go into it with an angry mentality, but I'm sure, you know, I'm going to try to be calm at first and just collected, I guess.
Zen it out. Right?
Yeah, zen it out.
Yeah, try it out.
A little bit of meditation.
I think your biggest challenge might be the one chip.
In the homegrown ghost pepper, sure.
This video is sponsored by Evan Thomas. You thought I was feeling you?
That's a munch. So first we're gonna start with regular Flamin' Hot Cheetos. You boys can eat your handfuls. When you're both done, I'll start a minute long timer. Go ahead. Next tier is Sriracha, so I'll get that set up.
Yeah.
Oh, he already finished.
It's like your finger, huh?
You have
unsanitary.
All right, so first round's finished. Now we're going to move on to Sriracha. Go ahead and put that down, boys.
Did we get a minute? Did you get
no.
us?
No. Just eat that. I don't care.
Eight zero calories.
Yeah, for real.
All right. So that round's over. Now they'll be moving on to the gold standard of spice, Frank's Red Hot. Spoonful for each. All right, go ahead and put that down.
This tasted like tomato soup.
Yeah, that wasn't.
Not bad.
I think Sriracha was worse.
Yeah, Sriracha was definitely worse.
We got Cheetos Extra Hot Edition. Supposed to be twice as hot as normal Flamin' Hot Cheetos, so we'll see if they live up to the name. Go ahead and put those down. Start the minute timer. Last thing before the Carolina Reaper peppers is these ghost pepper spicy chicken flavor ramen. I'm gonna give them a minute 30 to finish it, and then once that minute 30's up, we're gonna start another minute, and if they take a drink they lose, so we'll see what happens.
Grams of sodium.
All right, suck it up,
bro. I'm gonna be bloated. Holy cow. Holy mackerel.
He's a workhorse. I'm just saying.
Does it taste good?
Don't talk.
There's too much hotness for it to like.
How's he fine?
Dude, you gotta finish it.
I'm going, man.
Okay, they have both finished the ramen in under a minute and 30, and they will now wait for a minute to recover. Either of them take a drink. Okay, so they're eating the whole thing. All right, the minute is up. You have to get that whole ghost pepper chewed up and swallowed in 30 seconds, and then the timer will start for the next minute. Go ahead.
You've got 10 seconds. You're going to tap out if you don't eat them.
Oh my god, dude. There's no way.
He wins! He wins!
I win?
Yeah, you want to use tap?
Why did I eat tap? Why did I eat that?
And we're here with the post game interview. Grief, it looks like you're suffering.
I don't even look at it, bro. I'm not alpha anymore.
some raw emotion. Zach, you just put down that ghost pepper. How do you feel?
Yeah, I'm tingling and oh my god, it's hot. Oh,
my tongue is on fire. Zach, are you excited to compete again?
If it's like this, no.
Doing anything just to get you off of my mind. But when the morning comes, I'm right back where I started again. I'm trying to forget you was just a waste of time. Baby, come back. Any kind of fool. Zach, how are you doing? How are you feeling?
You know, it's the water's helping a lot, but I have to like always drink one. My lips are on fire, bro. It's rough.
Jake, how are we doing?
I can't. I'm sorry. I'm sorry for everyone out there who wanted to see me win.
You're good.
They're consoling each other. They're not even mad.
I'm disappointed in myself.
Date, Ron, how are we feeling?
Thirsty.
Thirsty.
Bro, I bet the ghost pepper was hotter than
me and Webb's current status. It's not that bad.